Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to today's reflection. Today I wanted to share a concept which I find really amazing, subhanAllah. A concept which I'd like to then connect to a hadith. And it is the weight of a word. And what a single word you say, what effects it can have. And the single word you say can have a massive positive effect, or even a massive negative effect, which wouldn't even come to your mind, which you wouldn't even consider. And I have my fair share of personal examples which connect to this. For example, this one time in the 8th grade, we were standing in our morning rows, and one teacher was telling us that whatever happened to the Quran, and that the Quran is not supposed to be just a thing which lies in your shelf and collects dust. And subhanAllah, that word, I feel, had a massive impact on my whole life, really. That was the turning point for me. And that's when I started to read Quran every day, just a single page, and that's all it was. And it really, really snowballed, alhamdulillah, to much greater things. Another experience of mine is that I'm talking to a beloved friend of mine, and just along the lines of the conversation, my friend says to me that I'm afraid of the day that I'll stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will ask me, why did you do this and why did you not do that? And I'll have to answer regarding my deeds. And this just shook me. And this same topic has been a cornerstone for me. In my talks, in my advice, the cornerstone is this concept of the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the single ayah, which is related to the same concept. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. That beware of the day in which you return to Allah, then every single soul will be recompensated for what it has done and they will not be wronged. SubhanAllah. And the third of these, and this will be the last, is actually a word by the brother Fahad Taslim from Sapience Institute, in which I ask a question which has been in my mind for a while. And the answer, once again, has colored a lot of my perspective, even the videos that I got here on the channel. His answer was focused on this point of not just knowing the names of Allah and knowing that Allah is the just, but rather internalizing the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like truly, truly trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was amazing for me. And what all of these have in common is this common denominator that none of these people actually got to see what the effect of that specific word that they said. They don't know, and they didn't follow the impact of what their word has led to. And when they said it, they didn't consider that it would have such an impact. But it has done plenty, subhanAllah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts barakah in the word, which is said with proper intention. Subhanallah. Now these are worldly and they're personal examples of the weight of the word, but even much heavier is the weight of the word on the Day of Judgment. And the hadith that I wanted to relate this to is quite the amazing hadith and the hopeful hadith, but at the same time quite the shocking hadith, which highlights this point that we have got to be very careful with where our tongue goes. And it is a hadith which is authentic, mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن العبد لا يتكلم بالكلمة من رضوان الله لا يلقي لها بالا يرفعه الله بها درجات وإن العبد لا يتكلم بالكلمة من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالا يهوي بها في جهنم. والعياذ بالله. That a man will utter a word so pleasing to Allah without even considering it of any significance, yet Allah raises his ranks in Jannah for that word. And another will speak a word which is so displeasing to Allah without considering it of any significance, and it's for the same word that he will sink down into hell for it. May Allah protect us. This just goes to show the weight of the word and how much of an influence a single word can have. So may Allah put barakah, put blessing in our words, and may He write for us His ridwan, His acceptance with us, and may He be pleased with us, and may He protect our tongues from uttering that which displeases Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may He forgive us for any sins that we considered insignificant, and may Allah protect us. This is what I wanted to share today. I wish you all the best. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.